Hi, how are you?
Good.
I'm Teresa.
Hi, Teresa.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Bernadette, and I'm from Belmore, Long Island, and this is my daughter, Nicole.
Okay. So have you guys ever been to a medium before?
Yes, I have.
Okay. They will make me feel the bond and relationship that you shared with them and also how they departed. Then they're going to talk about all of the things that have happened since they've died to validate for you that through every breath that you take, every milestone you achieve, they are with you in spirit. They are not missing out. I am going to say this, though, because I don't know. Is your mom departed?
Yes.
She is so excited. She goes, Teresa, they're really not here to talk to me, but I'm just so excited. So
it would be.
That would be her personality,
yeah.
Right? And where does the sister come in that died?
My sister.
She says that she wants to thank you for doing this for her sister. Because she makes me feel like I don't know if you would be able to do this without your mom. Who has the children? You have the children? You have like three of them? You have three children?
Yes.
She goes, they got so big. Someone just get their driver's license? Because they're showing me my nephew, Jason, who just passed his road test.
Well, my son Frankie will not be happy. He took his road test and he did not pass.
That's okay. But she just showed me my nephew, who just, it was last Friday, I think.
Same day.
And who's going to, or who is someone going to be, a teacher or a nurse?
My daughter.
Perfect. So just let
She's on the fence, actually. My sister was a teacher.
Oh.
And Olivia is in college for nursing, which she says, maybe I want to be a teacher.
This does not mean that your sister's saying, oh my God, be a teacher. So validating that your sister's soul was present for that. It is her soul getting your attention to say, I am here.
Hearing my sister validate recent things that are going on with my children really means a lot to me, and it will mean a lot to my children.
She was smart, ambitious. She taught first grade, and she was the best teacher that she could be. And that was very important to her. And she was the best person she could be.
Was there something done at the school in memory of her as well?
There was a big memorial at her school.
Because she shows me a tree and a bench.
Oh my God. Yes, we have a garden at the school district and I bought a bench. It says in memory of Janine and it has a saying. And we planted a tree. And then we had a big ceremony. It was amazing.
So know that she knows what you have gotten in memory of her.
We had a tree planted on a school grounds, and I had a bench made, inscripted personally in memory of Janine with some other saying on it. I mean, it just blew me away. And just that's exactly what we did. And then to mention that we had a big memorial at the school, which there was, that Janine was happy and that she was there for it. It really warms my heart.
She placed me in front of the casket and she showed me you like kind of fixing her.
I fixed her hair because I'm a hairdresser.
Perfect.
I didn't know what they did with it.
Go like this. So no, she says, I want to thank you for fixing my hair. And she said to me, Teresa, smile. And she goes, I looked so peaceful. It looked like I was smiling.
Yes, it did.
She said, I want you to view that as me not giving up. She says, of me being positive and knowing that I fought to the end.
She did.
My daughter Janine was probably one of the nicest people walking the earth. When I walked into the funeral home, I immediately went over and I didn't like what they had done to her hair. Hearing her thank me for that validates that she knows I was there and that she's with me all the time, and it just makes me feel good.
She put me next to the bed and I held her hand. And I actually watched her take her last breath. And I felt her soul move right through my physical body. So you felt that?
Yes.
So know that what you felt was your sister's soul to validate that she knew that you were there. And as you cried and as you prayed and told her that it was going to be okay, she says, I want you to know that I am okay. She says, it's just not the okay that we prayed for.
Right.
My sister Janine passed away almost 2 years ago from lung cancer. The final days were rough. I was with her, we were all there. In my head, I kept thinking, just give us another hour. Then it was another hour, can I have another hour?
I don't know firsthand personally, but I know from channeling the souls of the departed that it is not easy to watch someone take their last breath. That will probably have to have been the hardest thing that you'll ever have to do here in the physical world, is to watch your sister take her last breath, because she shows me you staring at her chest as she died.
I was watching her chest.
And then to see it stop, but then to feel her soul. She says, that was such a gift for me to give you.
See it all the time. When she passed, I was watching her her chest, because that's how I could tell that she was still breathing, and I was watching her chest go up and down. And then it just didn't anymore.
Were you in the room also, or did you just leave?
I just left.
Okay. She says, but I don't want you to feel that you missed out on something, because she has to live with that for the rest of her life, and it's not easy. She says, Mom, I'm so sorry. I didn't know how to say goodbye with you there.
I walked into the room, and she actually said to me, what are you still doing here? Because I don't know, she had the sense to know that it was late and I was still there. And I was crying, so I didn't want her to see me, so I turned around, and then I walked out.
She says, I don't want you to carry that burden. Do you understand that? Of feeling that you should have stayed.
I do feel like that.
She says there was no way you would have been able to stay, and you made the right choice that day. No regrets.
That was Janine, but she would always be more considerate, even at a time of death, to not want to upset me or to have me witness that, knowing that would be my last image of her. And that's exactly the kind of person that she was. It's just an amazing person.
So I want to thank you for giving me that honor and privilege of channeling your daughter's soul today, your sister's soul.
Thank you.
To be able to deliver those messages for you today.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best of luck. And again, I am so sorry for your loss.
I was always wondering if she knew I was with her and that I was holding her hand, and I got that answer today.
Thank you so much.
I'm very sorry for your loss.
You can't have closure after losing a child, but I can definitely feel like I can move on.
Good luck to you. Good luck on that road test. Larry and I have been avoiding issues in our relationship, and it's causing a lot of tension between the two of us. So this conversation is long overdue. There's just so many things going on in our life, and it's not anybody's fault. I mean, we can sit there and say, okay, this, that, but we're both not happy. I don't want the tension. I don't want any, I'm tired of crying every day.
What do we do from this point on?
I don't know. Do we do a trial separation? And I don't even know what that is.
That's really no different than the way things are right now.
I never thought in a million years that I would ever be saying a trial separation. But I feel that I don't know how to be who it is that I need to be and still be Larry's wife. I don't like it. I don't like the way the direction is going.
I just don't want it to continue like this.
I think our lives are just going in a different direction. And I don't know what to do with that. Yeah, I don't know. Things that used to make us happy, you know, both separately and as a couple, have just changed. It's like we lost our way and we have no idea how to find our way back.